पुराने कमजोर मेरा ये सवाल है कि जब हम मर जाएं और उसके बाद फिर जिंदा
अल्लाह ना
हो
करे। हाँ,
और उसके बाद फिर जिंदा हो और फिर जो कोई होता है वो बूढ़ा मरा हो या किसी के जो है ये कमर वो नीचे हो या कोई बेबी हो या कोई बीमार हो जब मरे तो फिर उसी तरह फिर जिंदा होगा और उसी
यही
तरह
तो।
रहेगा।
आई थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हेल्पिंग मी। द फैक्ट इज दैट वी मेंटेन अहमदीज दैट व्हेन यू आर गिवन ए न्यू लाइफ आफ्टर डेथ इट इज नॉट द सेम फिजिकल बॉडी विच इज रिवाइव्ड। बिकॉज इफ द सेम फिजिकल बॉडी इज रिवाइव्ड एज अदर्स अदर मौलवीज वुड हैव अस बिलीव देन दिस इज द बिगेस्ट ऑब्जेक्शन। ए काना वुड बी रेज्ड ए काना, there is one eyed person would be raised a one eyed person, and a person without eyes would be raised without eyes, a person without a leg or one who is paralyzed in the body would be raised as a paralyzed person, an old hag would be raised as an old hag. You see, so what a shocking concept of heaven or hell. You know, what is hell to, what does heaven mean to an old hag who is suffering from bone aches and things, you know, she can hardly move a finger without crying, and she would be raised exactly in the same way and go to heaven. What for? To suffer observing people enjoying heaven? It's meaningless. And we prove that Hazrat Rasool Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam never understood heaven to be something like this, or people to be raised in their physical bodies as they were found at the time of death. On the contrary, we find this very interesting anecdote, I mean, any very interesting incident. Once a very old lady visited Hazrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and asked him whether she would go to heaven or not. And Hazrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam smilingly retorted, "No old woman would be found in heaven." And she wailed and she protested and she cried like anything. "Oh, poor me. I wasted my time. Wish I were dead." You know, that's the type of thing. She wailed and wailed on. Then Ahasuerus smiled and said, "No, no, old lady, you will be made young. You will be reborn young." That was the message. So, the Holy Quran positively dictates. I mean, there's no time for quoting those verses. But the Holy Quran very positively, categorically dictates that the shape in which you will be reborn is something of which you can never conceive. It's not the same form. The Holy Quran tells us, tabdila is the word used, that you will be changed so drastically that as if you are completely a different thing. So when the Holy Quran categorically says that, and this logical as well, and it agrees with the traditions of Hazrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as well, why should we insist that the same body would be raised with the same, as you say, hunchback and broken knees and things?
जी, लेकिन मैंने आपको कुछ और पूछना है कि अगर फिर किसी और तरीके से किसी क्या उसे कहते हैं आएंगे कि उसी तरह नहीं जैसे पहले फौत हुए थे तो फिर उनको जैसे सजा मिलती है किसी को जिसने गुनाह किया हो और फिर उसे ऐसे दर्द होएगी जैसे कि अगर उसे अब चोट लगे?
नो नो, मे बी मच मोर इंटेंस। यू नो द फीलिंग यू हैव इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स। वन, यू have a physical pain, and sometimes you have an agony and you can't place where you feel it and how you feel it. And sometimes the agony is so strong that you wish you had a physical pain and not that agony. If a woman has lost her very dear only child, she doesn't suffer physically. There's no pain anywhere in the body. But the agony is so intense sometimes that she would give up her life. She would sacrifice anything for the sake of a revival of that son. So what is that agony and where is it felt? Can you imagine? Sometimes you have lost a pound or two and you feel pound or two and you feel some agony. If you are miserly, you feel a bit more agony. And if you are generous, well, still you feel a pinch here and there. But where is it felt? How it is felt? Can you describe?
Okay.
Is it hot or cold or, you know, like pinprick or like what? So the same soul which is here would be there. And it would feed the agony as Allah pleases.